Remember the Apple Vision Pros? Good times. Welcome to the highly anticipated Smartphone Durability Awards of 2024. We've posted a total of 77 videos this year, 78 including this one, and we have a combined total of 14.9 million hours of Jerry Rig Everything footage watched this year alone. That's the equivalent of one person watching my videos every day for the last 1,700 years. So thank you for lending me all of your eyeballs. It's actually your views and your watch time that has allowed us to get our wheelchair factory up and running this year. We have a new laser, a new CNC bender, and now are officially making the least expensive active wheelchairs in the USA by a very large margin. No one can beat our prices. And thanks to you, we also released our four-wheel drive off-road wheelchair called the Big Rig, thumbs up for that. We also built a life-size woolly mammoth out of metal, learned how real industrial diamonds are manufactured, did 2.5 seconds in the world's quickest electric truck, plugged an oil well that was leaking methane. We didn't have as much time to work on the bunker as I would have liked, but we did see how a factory in Africa was making their own human-powered off-road wheelchairs. And thanks to your book donations, we were also able to build a second library in Kenya. While we were there, we backed up a hospital with EcoFlow batteries so no one has to give birth in the dark, and we helped save a town from rambunctious elephants. But that video's not done quite yet, it's just been kind of a busy year. And if this video gets more than 5 likes, we'll do it all again, bigger, better, together in 2025. With all of that going on though, we still managed to durability test and take apart all of the smartphones and tablets on this table. Which means it is time to commence the Smartphone Durability Awards of 2025, starting with the most repairable smartphone. Which, hands down, has got to be the HMD Skyline, which is right here. With a single screw that pops open the back panel to access the internal components, there is zero heat required. And every component, battery and screen replacement, is available with same-day shipping directly from iFixit. And most importantly, self-repairs do not void your warranty. There is not a single phone on this table more repairable than the Skyline or the Fusion, which are the self-repairing phones marketed by HMD. A close runner-up though would be the Pixel line of phones, which is over here. They also have genuine OEM replacement parts publicly available on iFixit, but, and this is a big but, you have to use a heat gun and a lot of heat to soften the adhesive under the glass panel or the screen in order to facilitate those repairs. And that is just a hurdle or threshold that a lot of people just don't want to cross. And I don't blame them. Using a heat gun on a $1,000 smartphone is kind of an art form and not something that just immediately comes naturally to the repair oriented. Which makes the Pixel lineup of phones the runner-up instead of the main event. But what about the least repairable smartphones of 2024? Besides, you know, the folding phones, obviously, or the Vision Pro, obviously. The least repairable smartphone on my desk has got to go to the ROG Phone 8, which I didn't even bother putting back together. It's got a secondary screen on the back, three motherboards, two batteries, and a labyrinth of ribbons inside that would make even a Minotaur dizzy. Which is kind of unfortunate. Buying a piece of technology that I know can't be fixed just brings a level of anxiety that I just don't need in my life. Durability and repairability are both very large factors when I choose my own smartphone, but let's continue on to the most innovative smartphone of 2025. It was a very tough decision. For example, Huawei released their first tri-folding smartphone, which is incredibly innovative and incredibly cool, but there's always that longevity or durability aspect that I just can't help but factor in a little bit to all of the awards. There's just no way this phone can live for very long outside of a suit coat office slash desk job environment, and it most definitely failed my durability test. Seeing a colored e-ink tablet under a microscope though was incredibly cool and incredibly innovative, but not quite ready for the smartphone world just yet. So I have to go with the Red Magic Pro. Not only does it have a very well hidden, while still useful, front-facing underscreen camera, and the highest screen-to-body ratio of any phone I've ever seen, but it also has an RGB turbofan and liquid metal cooling system inside. It's genuinely impressive and more like a gaming laptop in your pocket than a smartphone, which is why it wins the most innovative smartphone of 2025. And by 25, I mean 24, but maybe 25, depending on if the smartphone manufacturers can stop making boring slabs of glass. We'll see how it goes. This brings us to the coolest looking smartphone on the inside of 2025. Yeah, the RGB cooling fan on the Red Magic 10 is really cool. See what I did there? But if I had to narrow it down, it would probably be a toss-up between, and I'll pick one, but it'll probably be a toss-up between the Pixel lineup of phones and the iPhones. Both of them have the copper coils in the back, which is just extremely aesthetically pleasing, but the iPhones have a row of magnets that orient the wireless charging pad, which look incredibly good. What I think shifts it in the iPhone's favor, though, are the sensor shift hardware up here by the main camera lens. That sensor shift hardware right there next to the camera lens is very representative of what's happening inside the phone, and we actually have teardown scans for most of the popular smartphones on this table. I actually have the X-ray scan on my Galaxy S24 Ultra. So if you want a skin for your own phone, I'll leave a link for that down in the description. It's very cool seeing all the insides from the outsides without the dangers of actually taking it apart. So if Santa Claus didn't get you what you want this year, treat yourself. What about the least durable smartphone of 2025? There were a few phones this year that did fail my durability test. The ROG Phone 8 did crack on the back, and the Pixel 9 Pro Fold is no more, even though the Samsung Fold and the Flip both survived. The nano-edged iPad and the world's thinnest iPad are both now iSads, but I agree that bending a full-size tablet is slightly outside of its normal use case, so we won't factor those into the least durable smartphone award. I think that award, again, goes to the Huawei Mate XT, because not only does it have the super soft center screen, but that center screen is exposed to the outside world when it's closed. It also sucks up rocks and dust like a Hoover, but that screen, which we already know scratches a level 2, is like walking around with a raw egg in your pocket. Super cool, don't get me wrong, but also definitely not super durable. So the least durable smartphone of 2024 goes to the Huawei Mate XT. The most durable smartphone award, drumroll please, goes to nobody's surprise, the Armor 24, which has enough built-in protection to survive a steamroller. It is IP69K water resistant and has a 22,000 milliamp hour battery, but it also, you know, doesn't quite fit in most people's pockets. Regardless though, it definitely wins the most durable smartphone of 2024, kind of by default. Two runners up though would probably be the CMF Phone 1, which has a plastic back, or the Nothing Phone 2A, which has a plastic back. Plastic is less likely to catastrophically shatter like glass, and most of the other phones released this year are just glass sandwiches. Remember though, any smartphone can be the world's most durable smartphone if you just put it in a case. Accidents are usually accidental, and protection is always a good thing. Would you have awarded any of these differently? Let me know down in the comments. And together, let's keep these smartphone manufacturers on their toes in 2025. Thanks a ton for watching, and I'll see you around.